Assalamualaikum everyone, this is the original Scary Ummi and we're here with episode 4 of Whip It Up Weekends being brought to you by Nestle Milkpak Cream. And today we have yet another celebrity chef to inspire you, to motivate you and to get you whipping it up. So today we have Sidra Shahid from Cooking 101. Hi Sidra, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good. So Sidra is only 28 years old and she's already a celebrity chef. So don't go by her age. She's been to Paris, she's been to Cordon Bleu, she's learned it all and she actually invents her recipes, which is like so cool, I think. Because somebody like me, you can't even like boil an egg, I'm like impressed.
We'll be doing apple crumble parfait. So actually we have fused two recipes together, a crumble and a parfait.
Great, so let's get started. What's the first thing we're gonna make?
Okay, so the first thing that we're gonna make is the crumble. That's the first element because we want to bake it and we want to cool it off. So that's the first thing that we're gonna make. All we need is about 3 crushed whole wheat slices or digestives that you can use. We have about 3 tablespoons of flour and 2.5 tablespoons of caster sugar. And we have about 3 tablespoons of butter as well. So either use soft butter or if you don't have soft butter and you just taken it out from your fridge, make sure that you melt it out, okay? Because you don't want your crumble, you want your crumble to be clumpy, but you don't want the butter to, you know, have hard butter at some point, okay? So first thing that we're gonna add in our bowl is our crushed digestives or the whole wheat slices. Then goes our 3 tablespoons of flour and 2.5 tablespoons of caster sugar. Make sure that your caster sugar is really fine because that will going to, you know, give you a perfect consistency of a crumble. That's why we're not using granulated sugar because it will take a lot of time in the oven to melt up. And then we require soft butter. See, my butter is really soft and this is what I'm looking for. If your butter is not soft, make sure that you just give it a go in a microwave, just melt it for 20 seconds and that's what you need. Now at this point, just get your hands in, make your hands dirty and just mix it up.
So my kids love doing this, so I love like cooking
involve
with my
kids. Involve your
kids
in this because of, you know, just involve your kids doing this kind of activity with you. Can you see that it's clumpy together? This is what we are looking for. Okay, now the best thing is that you can also add some oats, rolled oats in this. So a lot of people don't like that, but if I would have been making it for my family, I would have definitely added some rolled
like
oats.
Like good fiber.
Exactly, because it, you know, it gives you an authentic taste of a crumble.
Yes.
So, but this is something that you
always... So it's kind of like coming together.
Yeah, but you don't want it to have form a dough. You just want it to, you know, just clump together and that's about it. So we're gonna transfer it to the baking tray and then we're gonna bake it at 160 degrees for about 15 to 20 minutes. Just halfway through, take it out from the oven, just give it a shake, use a spatula and give it a shake on the tray and then pop it back in the oven. Okay, so make sure that both upper and lower grills are on and make sure that you place your tray in between the oven, okay? So in the middle of the oven, so it gives it gives you heat properly. And make sure your oven is preheated.
So many make sure.
Yeah, so you have to make sure that your oven is preheated at 160 degrees because if your oven is not preheated, obviously that will going to take a longer period of time. I'm going to place my crumble over this tray and see what I'm doing here is that I'm just making some flat surfaces with that, so it's easier for me to shake it and it forms a proper shape in the oven. Okay, so the crumble is out of the oven. And see how easy it is to make this and it just looks lightly golden and brownish and it's so nice and toasty. So you can even store it.
And it smells like amazing, like these roasted candy
exactly.
biscuits.
It always tastes really good and you can store it in an airtight container as well and you can also have it as a substitute for your granola and muesli with yogurt as well. So we're gonna transfer it to a clean bowl so that we can later use it for layering once it's cooled down.
So Sidra, what are we doing now?
Okay, so the next step is to prepare the salted butterscotch sauce. And for that, we're gonna use the soft brown sugar. So here we have about 1 cup of soft brown sugar, 1 cup of butter, we have about 1 cup of Nestle regular cream.
So the orange one.
The orange one. So we'll
like
be using
yummy.
Exactly. So we'll be using the whole pack in this recipe. And lastly, we'll be going adding our very fine sea salt to add that, you know, extra punch to your salt butterscotch sauce. I'm just simply amalgamating all the ingredients together. So for people who are beginners and who are, you know,
like me,
exactly. So who are trying out baking and they want to make fancy dessert, this is something very easy to
yes.
make. See, everything is immersed together. There is no outside film of fat or butter that you can see, and everything is nicely mixed together. And this is what we are looking for here. The sauce is done here. I'm going to turn off the heat, and the most important ingredient that will going to add a lot of flavor is our sea salt. So even if you don't have sea salt, what you can do is that you can use regular salt as well. We're going to transfer it to a bowl, and then we're going to let it cool down again, and then we're going to later use it in the layering.
And how many elements do we have total? Four.
So we just left with our apple pie filling that we're going to do right after this. Yeah. So I'm gonna transfer this sauce to a bowl so that it cools down in time, and then we're gonna use it in the layering.
Amazing.
Thank
it's
you.
Almost like melted toffee.
Yeah.
So okay. Step three,
yeah.
If I'm right.
Yeah.
And we have so many ingredients this time.
It does look so many ingredients, but trust me, it's very easy to make this step. So here I have 2 Granny Smith apples. We have cored it and you know, and chopped it. I don't like to peel it because all the flavor is in the flesh.
Oh,
yeah, so make sure that you just wash them very properly. Other than that, we have 1 tablespoon of soft brown sugar, 1 tablespoon of granulated sugar. We have 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon powder, 1/4 teaspoon of allspice, 1 teaspoon of lemon juice, and about 2 tablespoon of butterscotch sauce that we made earlier. But you have to make sure that it has come down to room temperature, because otherwise if you're going to use the hot butterscotch sauce, the fat might split. Okay, at a medium heat. We don't want a very high heat on our saucepan. We're going to add the apples.
I love the smell of like cooked apples.
Yeah, it tastes, it, you know, it gives you the cinnamon and allspice adds a very nice fragrance to it. Now I'm going to add soft brown sugar. Okay. And then I'm going to add the granulated sugar. So actually all of the ingredients will go together at once, except our butterscotch sauce. We're going to add our butterscotch sauce in the end. So it's basically done. All you have to see that the water and the juices from the apples are evaporated, because sugar will going to release its water, apples will going to release its juices. So once it's all evaporated, and when you see the apples are a little soft, that's the point it's done. You're going to turn off the stove, and then at that point we're going to incorporate our butterscotch sauce.
Achha, the butterscotch kafi kam dalti hai, kabhi aur bhi dalegi?
No, that's it.
Now stage 4.
Yeah, stage 4, and the most important stage is to whip up our Nestle whipping cream. So for that, we're going to prepare a chantilly cream. Now chantilly cream is a very basic sort of a cream that you serve with desserts, and for that you require whipping cream. And since we have this dairy cream nowadays, so this makes your work really easy, and that actually gives the actual and authentic taste to your chantilly.
Oh.
We will be presenting these this dessert in these short glasses.
Oh, cute!
So these are like a mini trifle bowls that we're gonna use.
Now assembly time, which is like the most fun.
Yeah. So what I'm gonna do here is that I'm going to transfer this whipping cream into my piping bags. You can also use a spoon or a spatula to transfer the cream into your shots as well. But this always makes your work, I believe, a bit easier and you are more organized that way. The first thing that we're gonna add in our shots is our prepared crumble.
Okay, like a first layer.
Cute. Yeah, so add a nice generous portion of the crumble. So, you know, a tablespoon enough is more than enough. The second element is our apples. See, the apples are nicely cooled down. Once you are adding your layers, you have to make sure that everything is at room temperature. That is of key importance. So what I'm going to do here is that, now that's optional, I am going to use half cup of chopped walnuts. Now we're going to add the layer of our whipped cream.
Yum.
We're gonna repeat the layers first. So for those who missed this, they can again see what we were looking
first
for.
First goes the crumble.
Yeah, so now at this point we're gonna add a slight layer of crumble. So a half tablespoon is more than enough. So this is how it looks.
It looks so good. Yeah. Time to taste.
Yeah. This is for you to taste actually.
It is amazing.
Thank you so much. I'm glad you liked
it. It's even better than I thought it would be. It's got like so much. I just want to keep eating.
Yeah.
It's got cream, it's got butterscotch, it has apples, it has textures, it has crunch.
Yeah.
Oh my God, this is like a winner.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you.